Gamer.
It's good to be with you again, sports gamers. Andre Ransom, content contributor for MLB The Show. And today is the day we finally get some in-depth information regarding MLB The Show 21's stadium creator. Now, many people in the community were disappointed, being that stadium creator is only going to be exclusive for next-gen consoles, the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S, as well as the PlayStation 5. But today we get some information regarding what all can be accomplished in Create a Stadium. And as some anticipated and as some feared, it looks like you can create any type of stadium monstrosity to your heart's desire. It was also mentioned that the ability to customize wall heights and foul pole dimensions will not be restricted. Now, that's going to be interesting to see how this plays out, because what happens when someone who is on a next gen console designs and creates a ballpark and then they get matched up with someone who's on a last gen console? How is that going to work out with regards to frame rate issues? Because online, the majority of players either play in classic stadiums or they play in minor league stadiums, being that many of the major league stadiums have frame rate issues, which causes the gameplay online to at times be unplayable. So it's going to be interesting to see how that works out when you have next gen consoles against last gen consoles. Now that there's cross-platform play implemented within MLB The Show, will there be issues online, or will they even give us? Now, we were told that you can take these stadiums into Diamond Dynasty, but it's still unclear if you will be able to face against your opponents online in Diamond Dynasty with these created stadiums. Now, it appears the 1,000 unique pieces that you can choose from for Create a Stadium will be packaged with multiple stadium kits ranging from present day architecture to fantasy. And so the layout for the Create a Stadium is almost similar to how Create a Logo is, where there are already pre-designed set pieces that you can take and manipulate to come up with your own type of logo for your team name as well as for your team jersey. So it's going to be interesting to see how these different kit pieces can be manipulated, or if they can't be manipulated at all, to form different types of stadium structures. Finally, players will be able to share their stadiums with friends and play or edit their favorite stadiums that they see in the online community. So this already affirms that there will be a stadium vault similar to the logo vault. And there are some awesome graphic designers in the MLB The Show community. So it's going to be amazing to see all of the different types of stadiums that will be created, and then your ability to manipulate a stadium that has already been created by someone else. So it's going to be great once we are able to actually see gameplay, live footage with these created stadiums that will be first done by the developers, no doubt, when they begin to live stream MLB The Show in the next couple of weeks. So it's really going to be fascinating to see how all of this comes together for MLB The Show 21. If you're not an SGO insider, I want to encourage you to sign up for a small subscription fee of $1 per month. This will give you access to in-depth articles, new information as it's released, as well as your ability to communicate with the SGO team. And if you're not subscribed to Sports Gamers Online, I want to encourage you to hit that subscription button, as well as put on the notification bell, so that when we release new information, you'll be the first to know. I'm Andre Ransom. This is Sports Gamers Online, your number one source for the sports gamer.